I am entering this court requesting that they acknowledge that I can maintain my rights under God's law. Will the court acknowledge that I can maintain my rights under God's law?
All the rights of every citizen. Please come forward.
So the court acknowledges for the record I retain the rights under God's law. The courts acknowledge. I have to retain myself here, sir. I cannot submit myself past the bar. It does violate my sincere religious beliefs. I hope it's not your intent to intimidate me.
Sir, I'm trying to speak.
Sorry.
And during the time I'm speaking, you're interrupting me. I will not stand for that. Understand?
I hear what you're saying.
No, you don't understand.
Is that an assumption?
What is your name?
My given name is Edward J. Robin. I am in no possession of the family name, therefore I cannot give it to you.
Are you Edward Bondservant?
The family name is not mine to possess, and I can give you my given name is Edward J. Robin, but the family name...
We'll
the family name...
We'll convict Mr. Bondservant in absence.
Excuse me, Your Honor.
Between now and 2:30, between now and 2:30, you can decide whether or not you're Edward Bondservant or not.
I hope that you can assume.
Well,
excuse me. I object. Can I object? Can I object, please?
You can object all you want, sir.
Can I object, please?
If you keep interrupting me, there's a couple of officers here. I'll have them remove you from the courtroom and take you to jail for the night. And then you can appear tomorrow morning, and you can decide just what you want to do as said.
Can I object?
You want to spend the night in jail?
Can I tell you no?
If you can tell me no, then you will show some respect to the court and you will do what I ask you to do, sir. This court stands adjourned until 2:30.
Can I let the court be known?
This court is adjourned, sir. You will keep quiet until we reconvene.
As you can see, an intimidation. Excuse me, I need your names and badge numbers for witnesses.
I got that.
Absolutely.
Okay, so your card? Great.
I don't have a card with me.
Okay, that's fair.
I think I do.
Yeah, I'm being greatly intimidated here. I'm not trying
that's
to play any games.
You're not being polite to the court, and you're
Excuse me, this is my witness as well. Do you believe I was intimidated?
Do you have a
there?
Pen, and do you wish to write down my name and badge number?
Yes, I do. Thank you. Let me get paper here.
Do you wish to write down my name and badge number?
I came over with the paper. Are you saying otherwise? Okay.
2653. Whitson, Whitson.
Okay, so,
Never mind. Strohan, STROH. AN and Reg 3032.
So then you both will give evidence to what you've seen today, then if you've drawn upon?
I will absolutely say what I saw, that's correct.
Okay, and will you do the same?
Yes, yeah? I will.
Well, thank you very much, appreciate it. And so that your name is Strohan?
Strohan, yes.
And your name is?
Whitson,
correct?
Correct.
Okay, thank you very much.
Your date of birth, September 52?
I came into this world on September 29th in 1952, and that's hearsay. And I wish you would write that down as well, but that is hearsay because that was just told to me, and I again relate it to you, third party, so that is definitely hearsay. And the way I'm led to understand is that hearsay is not allowed as evidence in court. Is that what you heard before?
And you were the
Church of Ecumenical Redemption International.
Do they have one of those churches in Edmonton here?
Yes. I'm the founder of that church. This is one of the ministers of the church as a fellow witness here to give evidence as to the intimidation and the failure of officers to uphold their duty and nuisance. 180 of the criminal code making me feel very uncomfortable because they're failing to perform their duty. And their duty is to protect me from those that would offend Her Majesty's law, which is the King James Bible. She swore to defend, and every officer should be aware of that, because of course ignorance of the law is no excuse.